This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and today our subject is Seneca Falls Feminists. This podcast briefly explores the first women's rights convention in Seneca Falls, New York. In July of 1848, Elizabeth Cady Stanton, Lucretia Mott, and others organized a conference of women to declare, discuss, and demand equal rights for women. Historians and women's studies scholars have detailed how the feminist movement during this time was directly related to the crusade for women's rights. This is in part because women activists were participating in anti-slavery discussions and groups. They were able to see their experiences under male domination as similar to that of enslaved Africans, and they noted the ironies of slavery and freedom and made comparisons to their own lives. In July of 1848, they launched a critical discussion of women's issues and in doing so laid the foundation for women's rights in the United States. There were 240 people in attendance. This included 200 white women and 40 white men. The delegates at the Seneca Falls Convention were made up of predominantly white middle-class feminists. The delegates to the conference presented a list of demands including the right to divorce, the right to child custody, access to the professions, access to higher education, and most significantly, the right to vote. The convention drafted a Declaration of Sentiments. This document copied the tone and intent of the Declaration of Independence. Their document stated, quote, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men and women are created equal," end quote. For white women, the Seneca Falls Convention laid the foundation for the women's movement. Other conventions were developed and held, and many prominent women became actively involved in women's rights work. The implications for African-American women were very different, according to scholar Shirley Yee in her article, Organizing for Racial Justice. It is significant to note that no black women were at the Seneca Falls Convention. Even though the majority of black women were in bondage and free black women only realized second-class citizenship. Dr. Yee surmised that this fact reflected the growing divergence between black and white women over the meaning of women's rights in the United States. For black abolitionist women and feminists of the time, women's rights included the elimination of racism as well as sexism. Even then, this point was at odds with the goals of many of the white feminists. The 1848 Seneca Falls Convention must be recognized as a serious and courageous activity of women's rights awareness and advocacy. At the same time, it should also be analyzed for the challenges to the goals of abolitionism and to the rights of black women.